So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today our topic is pharyngitis. Last class we have learned about tonsillitis. So today is our pharyngitis. And next class we may learn about conjunctivitis. So, what's the definition of pharyngitis? It is the inflammation of the pharynx. You can see in that big oral cavity and where that pharynx is lies in the body. It's a nasal cavity, paranasal sinuses, nostril is there, larynx is there. Above the larynx, there is a pharynx. The inflammation of pharynx is known as a pharyngitis. So pharyngitis is a, you can see in the picture that how where that is your pharynx is found over there. So inflammation of the pharynx secondary to an infection. It is a secondary infection mostly. There is the oral infection that leads to that one, pharyngitis. Inflammation of the pharynx secondary to an infectious agent. Most common infections agents are group A, streptococcus, and various viral agents. So it also coexists with tonsillitis. When there is tonsillitis, there can be chance of pharyngitis over there. Its etiology is that Streptococcus A, Mycoplasma, Streptococcus G, Streptococcus C, Corynebacterium, Diphtheria, Toxoplasmosis, Gonorrhea, Tularemia, Rhinovirus, Coronavirus, Adenovirus, CMV virus, EB virus, HSC virus, and enterovirus, HIV. These may cause the pharyngitis. So viral is most 90% is a pharyngitis is caused by virus. Mostly the common virus are rhinovirus, coronavirus, common cold, they may cause adenoviruses, pharyngo, conjunctival fever, acute respiratory illness, they may cause para-influenza virus, common cold for this, Krupp's, Coxsackie virus, Herpetgena, EB virus, infectious, mononucleosis, HIV. So these virus may cause the acute pharyngitis when it is a viral. Further, etiologies go, it can be viral pharyngitis, there can be bacterial pharyngitis. So, for bacterials, so the group A, beta, hemolytic, streptococci. Most common bacterial cause of pharyngitis. So it counts for 15-30% of cases in children and 5-10% adults, they may cause that group A, beta, hemolytic, streptococci. There can be mycoplasma, pneumonia, Arcanobacterium, Hemolyticum, Neisseria, Gonorrhea, Chlamydia, pneumonia, they can cause bacterial. So class symptoms, there can be fever, there throat pain, dysphagia, and viral, most likely concurrent URI, upper respiratory tract infection over there, symptoms of there, dysuria, nakben, and cough, hoarseness, gala kharab, conjunctivitis, aankh, nisapani, and ulcerative lesions, their chances. Streptococcus, look for associated headache hoga saath, abdominal pain ho sakta hai. Fever and throat pain are usually acute in aansa zyada temperature aur gale mein dard hoga. Throat pain ho sakte hain pharyngitis mein. On physical examination, if it is a viral, ABV, white exudates, pus hogi, usme covering, erythromatous, pharynx and tonsils, cervical adenopathy, then acute chronic symptoms, fatigue, malgesias, transubia, infected saliva, adenovirus, coxsackie, vesicles, ulcerative, there can be parts honge wahan pe throat pe. Ye cyst ban jati hai, slack ban jati hai, back ban jayenge vesicles mein. Lesion present on pharynx or posterior soft palate. So they can lead to also look for conjunctivitis. आँख की सोजिश हो जाएगी, कंजक्टिवाइटिस के चांसेस हैं व्हेन देयर इज ए फेरिंजाइटिस. सो एपिडेमियोलॉजी ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल फेरिंजाइटिस, इट इज स्प्रेड बाय कॉन्टैक्ट विद रेस्पिरेटरी सिक्रेशंस, पीक्स इन विंटर एंड स्प्रिंग. देयर चांसेस इन विंटर, एट स्कूल एज देयर आर चांसेस. कम्युनिसिबिलिटी हाइएस्ट during acute infection. Patients no longer contagious after 24 hours of antibiotics. If hospitalized, droplets precautions needed into then they cannot, it is a contagious, they can be from spread from respiratory secretions. On physical exam, if it is a bacterial group A streptococcus, looks for whitish exudate covering pharynx and tonsils, tender anterior cervical adenopathy, palatal, uvular, petechy, spread via respiratory particle droplets, no school attendance until 24 hours after initiation of appropriate antibiotic therapy. If absence of viral symptoms, rhinorrhea, cough, hoarseness. Now, supportive complication of group A streptococcus, they may lead to then otitis media, sinusitis, peritonsillar, and retropharyngeal abscesses. Supportive cervical adenitis, they further aggravate if they cannot be treated pharyngitis. So non-supportive complication of group A streptococcus is acute rheumatic fever is chances, follows only streptococcal pharyngitis, not with the group A streptococcus. Skin infections, it's acute glomerulonephritis may follow pharyngitis or skin infections. Nephritogenic strains, there are chances of that one. Now you can see in pharyngitis picture how this area is inflamed, mouth inflamed in pharyngitis. Further, you can see in these pictures that how the whole area uvula is also inflamed over there. It can happen over there when there's a pharyngitis over there. Further, you can say that pharyngitis in this picture, how it's happened, the uvula is closed due to infection over there. Further, you can see in this pharyngitis how this aggravates the condition of the patient when there's in sore throats, mouth, throat is over there. So clinical manifestation when the infection by the streptococcus, rapid onset, headache, GI symptoms are also reported. There are sore throats, erythema, exudates coming, palatine, petechies, enlarged tonsils, anterior cervical adenopathy, and tender red and swollen uvula is found when on clinical manifestation over there. Further, there is a gradual onset. If there is a viral pharyngitis, it's a gradual onset. Dysuria is there, cough is there, diarrhea is there, and leads to fever. You can see the viral pharyngitis over there. Different patches you can see in this picture over there. Treatment. Now, what the treatment can you suggest as a pharmacist? You can apply antibiotics, acetaminophen, and warm salt gargle. At your age, you can, if this warm salt gargle can be done, so it's can avoid from that infection. Then steps of penicillin, erythromycin, azithromycin can be done. So macrolides drugs can be, erythromycin and azithromycin are macrolides. So can be done penicillin. Nowadays penicillin is not used, and erythromycin is also outdated now. Mostly now they are macrolides. Clarithromycin, azithromycin are mostly used in these soft tissues. If carrier of streptococcus, then clindamycin, amoxicillin, calvulanic, that is Augmentin, or they have other brands also of amoxicillin plus calvulanic acid. Retropharyngeal abscesses, then we add what it has to be, drainage plus antibiotics can be given. Peritonsillar abscess, if there is, then penicillin and aspiration has to be done with the soft needle or whatever, it has to be drained out when there is a peritonsillar abscess over there. Pharmacotherapy. So first, penicillin V is the drug of choice in patients who can swallow pills. Those who can take oral pills, they can have penicillin V tablets. If using suspension, amoxicillin is the better tolerated, tastes better than penicillin V. Amoxicillin has a single dose, 1 gram per day for 10 days in an effective as penicillin V, or amoxicillin given multiple times per day for 10 days. Mean 4 times a day or 3 times a day, the amoxicillin can be given. A single dose of intramuscular penicillin. So parenteral can be advisable. A single dose of intramuscular penicillin G, benzathine, improves adherence but is painful if you apply injectable over there. The patient is allergic to penicillin but has no history of type 1 hypersensitivity to penicillin, a 10 days course of first generation cephalosporin can be given. First generation of cephalosporin is indicated. Who will tell me about any first generation drug? Any first generation cephalosporin, who will tell me about this drug? Anyone know that one? Ji bacho.
Sir, cephalexin.
हाँ जी जी बोलो बेटा.
Cephalexin, cefotaxil. So these are the first generation cephalosporins.
First generation भी दी जा सकती है. Good. Oral clindamycin is an acceptable alternative if one is unable to use the first generation. So if first generation is, then they can use the clindamycin. Clindamycin belongs to which group of drug?
Lincosamide, sir.
Very good, very good. So then a macrolide is also acceptable for patients allergic to penicillin. The macrolides are called azithromycin, clarithromycin is widely used. Erythromycin is outdated, both it is effective. Erythromycin was the first, I think. Macrolide, they both used that. Now azithromycin or clarithromycin, which suspension is if they have azithromycin has a suspension and clarithromycin also suspension, so that can be given macrolides. So if there's a recurrence of gas pharyngitis shortly after completing a course of an oral antimicrobial agent can be treated again with the same agent. So given alternative oral drug or given an intramuscular injection of pens. So if there's a recurrence of the, again it happens pharyngitis, so then it can be applied over the intramuscular injection of penicillin G, benzathine. Expert opinions may be differs. Antibiotic must be started within 9 days after onset of acute illness. Within 9 days after onset of acute illness and continues for 10 days. So the therapy goes for 10 days. Or 5 days for azithromycin, to eradicate group A streptococcus from the upper respiratory tract and prevent acute rheumatic fever. Further treatment, if you can have viral supportive care only, and viral you can have antiviral, no antiviral for this, then analgesics, antipyretics, and fluids can be added. Analgesic, maybe that one, acetaminophen, paracetamol have to be added. And paracetamol has also antipyretic activity over there, so it also relieves the pain and also temperature. Supporting use of oral or intramuscular corticosteroids for pain relief. There's no chance, evidence of dexamethasone, or they may be added. Few studies shows transient relief within first 12 to 24 hours after administration of. If there's a EBV infections, mononucleosis. So activity, what restrictions? Mortality in these patients most commonly associated with abdominal trauma and splenic ruptures happen if it is not treated pharyngitis.